Go.
Well, hello there, you multi mega moments. Yes, Ralphie here with another whisky review. Not quite sure which number it is, but as it's surfacing just before Christmas 2011, it'll be between the 230s and 240s, but I will annotise about it. But I could also annotise where we are at the moment, but for all you Glaswegians and folk who have visited Glasgow, you may recognise Bath Street, and we're right in the city centre with its wonderful architecture, and heaven help us, the rain is almost off. But we're here for a purpose, as you know. It must be something to do with whisky, and here it is. It's the Good Spirits Company. Yes, I have a little helper in the camera. I will introduce him later. Some of you will know him. And this is just opened up. It's three young drink fans with quite a bit of experience between them, who are going out on their own and offering quite a diversity of spirits. We're going to take a wee trip down the stairs here, and I'm going to point out some of these spirits to you and basically highlight for your infotainment the benefits of a specialist retailer. I'll lead. Mind your feet in the steps, cameraman. Here we go. Good news, folks. They're open. Hello, Shane.
Hello.
Nicely laid out. Not too fussy. Not too much flannel, not too much ostentation. The very epitome of a modern bottle shop, as you would call it. Now, we're going to start with the whiskies at the moment, just over here in the shelves. Bruichladdy, the Classic 10. You will be hearing more from me about this, particularly bottling, before the year is out. And the reason being, this is a very good example of a contemporary craft single malt whiskey. So, here we are, £33 a bottle. That's a pretty good price. And as you'll notice when you're in, the Islay whiskies tend to be grouped together because of their phenolic peaty character generally, but not all of them. The Bunahabhain and the Bruichladdy tend to be that little bit softer and not quite as phenolic. Classic stuff here, the 10-year-old Ardbeg. It tends to get overlooked, guys, because with all the fuss about Alligator and Kildaltons and Supernovas Part 1, Part 2, Part 3, 4, 5, 6, it tends to get overlooked a wee bit, as does the Laphroaig Quarter Cask. Both are excellent Islay whiskies and value for money. Moving along the shelf a little bit, don't forget Kilhoman. It's the new star from Islay. Some strongly peated whisky, but importantly with Kilhoman, the quality at a young age is very good indeed. Moving along a bit further, we're coming to Glenfarclas. Now, what would I highlight with Glenfarclas here? Probably the 105 cask strength at the moment. The reason being that you have a few affordable, generally available cask strength whiskies out there, like Laphroaig cask strength or Aberlour Abenas. That's a cask strength single malt as well. And they're well worth looking out for if you're familiar with some of the standard single malts, because they're that higher strength in alcohol, carrying more flavour. And don't forget, you need to add some water to them. Now here we are, there's some independent bottlings. Glentochars, Linkwood and Balmenach, getting a mention here, Duncan Taylor stuff, and presentation whiskies. I've not seen this one before. This is obviously got a kind of honey reference with the hexagonal shapes here. Anok, a bottle and two glasses, depending on the time of year, whether it be Christmas, birthdays, or whatever anniversaries. Some of these presentation packs, they're pretty good value. Moving a bottle along, one you might not necessarily know, Tomatin and Deanston. Tomatin is going through a little bit of a rediscovery, reinvention at the moment. There's some very good Tomatins out there, well worth looking out for, and not too expensive. And of course with Deanston, it's another single malt. It's been off the radar, but it's kind of reinvented itself as a craft bottling single malt. Cask strength, non-chill filtered, no added colouring, and it works. It's certainly a big improvement. Now we've got with specialist bottle shops like the Good Spirit Company, what you do have is you've got range, and importantly, the guys behind the counter, or the girls behind the counter, wherever you are, they've got a tremendous amount of experience, because generally they're quite keen in what they do. So if you have any doubts, or if you're looking for any information, whether it be about whiskey or about the local whiskey scene wherever you are, the bourbon scene wherever you are, just ask these folk, because it's highly likely they'll know. Moving on a little bit past some of the blends, which should not be overlooked, the blended whiskies, the blended scotch and the blended malts. We're moving into bourbon and rum territory. Now, these tend to get a little bit overlooked by the whiskey snobs who say, you know, there's nothing finer than single malts. And the fact is that the landscape is changing significantly. There's some very good rums out here. And here's one I'm going to bring up and show you, is Ray and Nephew Overproof. Jamaican rum is to rum what Islay is to whiskey. Jamaican rum is big, aldehyde, syrupy, full-flavoured rum, about as strong as you can get, and none comes much stronger than this Ray and Nephew at 62% alcohol. Great, by the way. Seriously good in cocktails, because it's the so full-flavoured, it doesn't get drowned out by whatever you're adding. What else? Oh, here we are. Some of the single cask rums are also well worth looking out for. Bristol Classic Rum, Bristol Spirits, they've been on the go quite a while, get pretty good stock. And coming down the shelf a little bit, we have got Cachaça. Now, here's one that I reviewed recently, gave a pretty favourable response. Again, so much lighter than whiskey, different nature, completely different, but well worth checking out. And you may be interested to know, if I just open this nice anonymous white door, what lies therein? Well, it's a brand new tasting room. There we go. Thank you very much, Mr. Cameraman. Showing the quality of the floor there, and why not? And got some paintings, by the way, to decorate the place by Ian Gray, the artist, and general good guy. But slightly echoey in here at the moment, but I'm sure once they've got their tartan wall hangings, the place will be looking lovely. And I have been told they've just had the first rum tasting in this room recently. Thank you, Mark. Also worth pointing out, in a specialist liquor store, a bottle store, is the availability of cigars. Cigars tend to go well with different spirits. Let me give your opinion here. It really doesn't matter too much which spirit goes with which specific cigar. There's a little bit of waffle going on there. What I generally find is, say, a good cup of coffee with a cigar and maybe some sweeter rums, they go really well together, because with more delicate spirits, the smoke that you're taking into your mouth from a cigar can get a little bit lost, you know, can kind of lose the spirit. So a good range there, Cuban, Nicaraguan and some Honduran cigars. Moving over to the other side of the specialist retail bottle shop, we have got other options that tend to be overlooked: cognac, Armagnac and brandy. They tend to have been fairly generic for a while, dominated by a few big industrial brands. But there are, particularly the Armagnac, is what I would personally recommend here, is some very interesting flavours to be found that you won't necessarily come across in whiskey. Next we have the vodkas. Smoked vodka. Who'd have thought? There we go. You can also... We're getting the availability. I'll be reviewing this, by the way, and I'll be reviewing this one before too long. That'll be for something for 2012. The one thing about vodka is it tends to get overlooked because it's regarded as flavourless. Well, it's not technically true. It depends how the quality, the intrinsic quality of the vodka, it can have its own particular flavour, and importantly, it responds well to other flavours that are added to it. Moving along, tequilas and mezcals. Let me see. Here's one I'll be reviewing before too long. I remember buying a bottle of this, made from the juice of the agave, which people think is a cactus, but it's not. It's a lily. So there you have it. Now, moving along a wee bit further so we conclude this little vlog, because I know you've got your coffee, the kettle to put on, make your coffee and tea, whatever you happen in, you malt mates. We are arriving at liqueurs. Here's one. I won't say too much about it. We'll just have a wee look at the berries floating around in this bottle. Now, for someone who doesn't like whiskey and you're looking for a bottle of something for them, what better? Our limoncello, fantastic. One of the properties of alcohol is its ability to carry flavour intact, complexity of flavour intact. And we're just going to have a wee wave with Shane there. Hello, Shane. Have you got a wee brief message for the whiskey fans?
Drink less, but better quality.
Excellent advice. And finally, we're going to conclude this vlog as I grab the camera and pass over the microphone to Mark, just to say a few words about the Good Spirit Company and the website.
Good morning, Ralph. Thanks for coming in to the Good Spirits Company. Go and see www.thegoodspiritsco.com for more information about our lovely little shop.
Excellent.
And we will play you a nice little record if you ask nicely.
Splendid. And three bits of advice on buying in a specialist retail bottle shop.
Number one, don't be afraid to ask us. We'll give our personal opinions and thoughts on anything that you're looking to buy. Ask to try things. We're quite happy to let you try things before you buy if we have it open. And number three, don't be afraid to try something different.
Thank you very much.
Is that good enough?
Thank you.
Cheers, Alfie.